Scientists and science communicators have always highlighted how science affects our everyday lives. High-tech devices, food, vaccines, drugs, and energy production, just to mention a few. But making science accessible to everyone is a challenge for science communicators around the world. And for some people, it is even harder to understand the language used to explain science, because some people simply can't hear it. But why it is important to engage deaf people in science? Vivian Rujanek, a professor of the Federal University of Rio de Janeiro in Brazil, says,
"You may ask, why go into the trouble of teaching science to the deaf? And I may reply, why teach science to anyone? Why teach science altogether? Is it to form future scientists, or is it to give people their citizen right to know and to be able to have an opinion on the scientific technological society we live in? I believe it's the latter."
Rujanek is a biochemistry researcher. In 2005, however, she started a project designed to reduce the barriers that make it difficult for deaf people to access science.
"Deaf people are invisible, and we tend to forget that they exist. Even more, we forget that they may suffer constraints in our society due to their difficulties in communicating with listeners. The deep realization of the need to communicate came from an experience I had many years ago in China. It was a different China then. People only spoke Chinese. My English, French, Spanish, and Portuguese were of no avail. People did not understand me, and I could not understand them. And of course, I could not read their characters."
Rujanek realized that Brazilian Sign Language, called Libras, lacks signs related to science. To help fill this gap, she has been created a glossary of new signs recorded on a DVD. She and her team, which includes both deaf and hearing people, have already created three sections on blood, immune system, and the cell. Each has about 100 signs. Another section on fertilization and embryo development is being prepared. Rujanek and her team also run short courses to give deaf high school students an opportunity to work in a laboratory. Each course is based on a scientific topic such as coagulation, why we stop bleeding, the invisible world of the microbes, and food. Students decide what they want to learn about the subject, suggest hypotheses, undertake experiments, and discuss the results with their colleagues. Rujanek is aware, however, that this is only one step in addressing this important issue. According to the World Federation of Deaf, there are 70 million deaf people in the world. About 8% of them don't go to a school, and less than 2% of deaf people are taught sign language. The situation for deaf women and children is particularly bad. Therefore, the question remains how to enable deaf people to fully engage in society as a whole, and in particular in science.